You can see here this reductions and this reduction, this reduction and this reduction, right? And from where they are coming, you know, this R3s are coming from S4, and this R3 is came from 7. So this is one item set, and I4 is here is another item set, right? So as their look aheads are different, they have created different states. But it also one thing good with this is that so this is first let this is basically LR1 parts table. Okay, so one thing it assures that even this state is, you know, this table is little bit long, as these states are not merged together, right? So they are not merged together, so it becomes a little bit long, but it gives a better chance that accommodate a grammar in LR1 parsing, right? But at the same time, if you find that what about if we want to merge them based on the look ahead or keeping the look ahead, you know, by taking union of the look ahead, you can say. Say I merge, you know, I4 and I7 together, and the, it will give us, you know, say I4 7, okay, it will give us C to D dot look at the C or D or dollar. So as long as if we do this, and it is not going to create any conflict in the table, right? In this table, like any conflict means any reduce conflict or shift reduce conflicts are not going to be introduced if we are going to merge the similar states, then what will happen? We can do it, right? Yes, we can do that. Then it will be called as LALR parser. Stands for look ahead LR parser. Okay, so LALR parsers are often used in practice because LALR parsing tables are smaller than LR1 parsing table. Definitely, because in LR1 we had kept this fourth state and seventh state separate, but in LALR we will merge them as say I4 7 together. Okay, as long as it is not going to introduce any conflict. So the number of states in SLR and LALR parse table for grammar G are equal. Okay, so number of states are going to be equal in LALR and SLR. So number of, if sometimes question comes that if you are having a LR1 table, then if you generate SLR table for this, then which will have greater number of states? So definitely LALR having greater number of states than SLR, and you can say it is having less number of states of LALR, but at the same time SLR and LALR are having same number of states. Understand? But LALR parsers recognize more grammars than SLR parsers. Because in SLR, what was happening? So we have to remember, right? SLR was doing it based on follow. Okay? LALR is doing it based on look ahead. Understand? So there is the difference. YACC, what we had done in our lab, it creates LALR parser for a given grammar by default. Okay, so a state of LALR parser will be again a set of LR1 items. Okay, so LALR parser always generated from LR1 item set, what we have just learned to generate. Okay, creating LALR parsing table, how we do it? We have say canonical LR1 parser. Okay, we can convert it to LALR parser by shrink the number of states. Shrink the number of states means merging them. Okay, so this shrink process may introduce a reduce conflict in the resulting LLR parser. So the grammar is not LLR. So that is what I am telling you. I was telling you that if it is going to reduce, because there is chance that as you are merging multiple states from LR1 item, say, it can introduce some reduce conflict. So if it is doing that, it is happening, then we will say that for this grammar, LLR is not possible. So that grammar is not LLR. Okay. But this string process does not produce a shift reduce conflict at all. Okay. So this is another good thing. This merging process can give you only reduce conflict, but it will not going to give you a shift reduce conflict. Okay. So say this is what we had done, right, for this grammar. And you can see here, we can merge them together. How we can we're merging here, you can see this fourth and seventh are now going to be merged as, say, item 4, 7 and item set 3 and 6. These two things are going to be merged as item 3, 6. Okay. And 8 and 9 together, we can, and they are having same item set, but look at the different. So we merge them. We create a item set, you know, i 8 9. Okay. So we don't have any more any i6, we don't have i7 anymore, we don't have i8 anymore, we don't have i3 anymore, i4 anymore, and any, because they are being masked. Okay, so this is our you can say LLR transitions or item sets, and from here we can create this parse table, and this will be called as LALR parse table. Okay, so anybody can generate this parse table. I don't think we need to regenerate it again. I think we all understand this.